in SportsCenter AM.
We think we know the four, but who's number one? Ohio State and LSU making their cases with Clemson waiting in the wings for the team that ends up second. Why our insider thinks we might see a change at the top just hours before the final decision from the playoff committee. And James Harden deciding to get chippy. What's going on between the beard and Devin Booker? SportsCenter AM here for you with answers on Sunday Funday.
Oh boy. That a boy, Joe. Run, Joe, run.
First time on TV. Hi, man. Hi, dad. Hi, family. I'm here in Dallas.
Hi, mom and dad.
I mean, we sort of have a Metroplex bias today because we're taking you to Grapevine, Texas, which is sort of in that area. We're properly caffeinated with you. One of us is. SportsCenter AM Sunday morning.
More.
Cole Briscoe, Randy Scott alongside. James Harden got frustrated and physical with Devin Booker. Next stop, New York for Joe Burrow, but we start in Indy.
Yeah, my holds.
Stamping
my cheese
plane
holds.
Tickets. Just pop, pop.
Bad. Second half holds. Badgers, Ohio State. It's the Big Ten title game from Indianapolis. We're going to start second quarter. Wisconsin was already up 7-0, and Jack Cohn fakes the handoff, and we're going to get a really high pitch because that's a touchdown, and Wisconsin's now up 14-0. Minute to play in the half. Second and goal for Ohio State. J.K. Dobbins. Handoff, touchdown, so now it's 14-7. Next Wisconsin possession, 42 seconds to play in the half. Jonathan Taylor runs left down the sideline, gets into Ohio State territory. It's a 45-yard gain. He had 13 carries, 135 yards, and a touchdown in the first half. Cone now. Oh, I do it all by myself. His second rushing touchdown of the half. There were 194 rushing yards in the first half for Wisconsin, and Justin Field just looked a little rattled, frazzled, but adjustments. Ryan Day said the mood at half was, we are not going down like this. Fields to Jeremy Ruckert, so now at 21-14. 3 minutes to play in the third. Ohio State down 21-17. It's first and 10 from the 16. Garrett Wilson appears to false start, but I only have eyes. The ref misses it. Fields to KJ Hill, who is now the Ohio State all-time leading receiver. And that is the first lead of the game for Ohio State. Ohio State scored 17 in the third. And then in the fourth, they added some more. So it's 27 unanswered. Wisconsin had just 6 rushing yards in the second half. Benjamin Victor picking up the big first down. Hill going to get a touchdown. It's 34-21. It's the third straight Big Ten title for Ohio State. And Ryan Day says his team has done enough to easily be number one. I mean, Wisconsin's the third-ranked team they've beaten in as many weeks. You be the judge.
You like beating AP top 10 teams, then LSU is your huckleberry. They got the fourth-ranked Georgia Bulldogs in the SEC championship game. And if the Dogs are going to hold on to that fourth spot, they got to go through the Heisman frontrunner in Joe Burrow. And LSU fans in Atlanta chanting Heisman, Heisman at Burrow. And I'm not saying this is a Heisman moment here because we actually have a better candidate later in the highlight, but anytime you can catch your own deflection and advance the football, it might be your day. Here's your coach.
That a boy. That a boy, Joe. Run, Joe, run.
I have a new ringtone, and it's Coach Ed Ogeron just laughing and giggling. Look at the amount of time. Look at the amount of time that Joe Burrow has.
He read War and Peace.
To let this thing develop. I mean, 9 seconds, 8.8 seconds. So just about 9. We're going to round up. He finds Ja'Marr Chase. Chase, 18th receiving touchdown, tying the single season record in the SEC. It would stand up to review for Burrow. It's passing touchdown number 45. That breaks a single season SEC record. It was a tie previously held with Drew Locke. Later in the quarter, LSU, red zone, LSU, end zone. Terrence Marshall, Burrow, 9 of 10, 123, 2 touchdowns in the first quarter, and it's 14-0 Tigers. LSU leading 20-3 in the third, Burrow in the shotgun. And he's going to evade Trayvon Walker not once, but twice. That's unfair. Georgia safety J.R. Reed said he's a great athlete. We had plays we were supposed to make. He just squeezed out of it. And there he finds Justin Jefferson. Jefferson, chunk play, 71 yards. Burrow said it was all improvised. We got a great feel for each other, talking about his connection with his receiver. This is the Heisman moment. That's what we were alluding to earlier. Burrow accounting for 390 total yards. That's tied for the third most in SEC championship game history. Later in the drive, you're going to cap it off. You're going to find Marshall for an easy touchdown. 349 through the air, four touchdowns for Burrow. Becomes the first quarterback to throw for four scores in the SEC title game since Cam Newton in 2010. And if memory serves, Cam Newton went on to win a national championship as well. The parents are digging it. The fans are digging it. It's the fifth win over an AP top 10 team for LSU this season. That ties a record in the AP poll era. You look now at the percent chance to be the top seed. You know about the playoff, that's fine. What about number one? After weeks 13 and 14, Ohio State was in the driver's seat, but now, according to the All-State playoff predictor, LSU has closed that gap. Buckeyes Tigers, about an even chance for that top spot. We heard both schools, both coaches, make their respective cases, starting with Coach O.
Why should you be number one?
Well, whatever it is, it don't matter to us. Whoever they tell us to play, we're going to get it.
You know, we'll play anybody anywhere. Send us to Canada, and we'll play on a gravel lot. Doesn't matter to us.
I think when you look at our resume and what we've done, beating Wisconsin when they're a top 10 team twice in 1 year, and then, you know, again, this three-game stretch was unlike I think any team has had in the country. Again, if there's a better team out there, I'd like to see them.
In my heart, I think we should be number one, and I hope we are.
I think we're number one, point blank, period. I just feel like a team like this that, you know, hit a lot of adversity and has been tested, you know, many times in times like today. And to see us come back and not just come back, but we came back and we dominated. And I feel like a team who could just flip the switch like that is a number one worthy team.
You know, LSU's been an unbelievable team. I would imagine they'd be one. I think they won pretty big, didn't they? I didn't see the end of it, but they were winning pretty big. And then what was the Ohio State score? I don't know. Was it close? So pretty close game. I don't know.
It doesn't matter to him. He just wants a spot. So we have our football brain trust. We have Paul Feinbaum. We have Jonathan Vilma with us. And Paul, I want to start with you. And I want to sort of get a consensus here. The four teams, right, we're all in agreement. Ohio State, LSU, Clemson, and Oklahoma.
Agreed.
Okay. Agreed? Are we on the
Agreed.
Same page?
Yeah. Okay.
Who most deserves to be on that top line number one, Paul?
You have three legitimate number ones. I'm going with LSU based on what they have done yesterday. It's early in the morning here on the East Coast.
You're fine. Don't worry about it.
They have not had a great defense all year. And finally, in the last couple weeks of the season, this looks elite. And Jonathan, I think that's tipping the balance. I respect what Ohio State's done. They have struggled a little bit against Penn State and against Wisconsin for the second time. They did destroy Michigan, though.
Yeah, I don't think Michigan was that great of a team. I have LSU number one as well. After watching yesterday, when I watch Ohio State, they were peaking very early in the season. That's why they were so dominant. And now you look at them late in the season, they're still a very, very good team. You can make a great case for them to be number one, but you start to see some holes in the defense, particularly in the run game, because that wasn't the first time that a team was able to run on them. Penn State was able to run the football on them, and that was the knock on LSU. All of a sudden, LSU has corrected that issue. Ohio State hasn't, so LSU bumps up to number one.
The knock on Clemson is that their ACC schedule is on the weaker side of things. They won by 45 points.
Yeah, they're the most dangerous team right now.
Okay, so they're the most dangerous team, but who should be most afraid to play them? Because they're likely going to be the three seed. So is it LSU or is it Ohio State?
Yeah, and I've been the biggest critic of Clemson, but to me, they look like a legitimate number one team, even though they'll be number three. I would say Ohio State, because I just don't like the trajectory. And I know we're splitting hairs, but that's what you do on the final day of the season when there's really not that much else to quibble about. But they just look like they've dropped a little bit. And LSU is ascending, and that's why I think Ohio State would rather not see Clemson. Also, a couple of years ago, they played Clemson. They lost 31-0.
I remember.
I do. Yeah,
and Clemson, I talk about them being the most dangerous because their quarterback is finally playing great football. And because he's playing so well, they are right now the best team in the land. And Ohio State has a big issue. I would actually put Clemson number two.
Would you?
And Ohio State number three right now because I'm watching the way that Clemson plays defense. It's been consistent all year. Then the run game for Clemson is really going to give Ohio State issues.
Okay, so that's interesting. Mm-hmm. Do you? But you have them at three?
Yeah, but I will tell you, we sit here every year and do this. This is the most difficult. You could argue any one of the three for number one, and I don't think you would get a strong debate on the other side.
Yeah. Okay, so despite the Clemson weakness of strength of opponent or whatever the schedule may say, it's how they're winning. that's showing up and showing out.
And they've been winning by a lot.
Changing minds.
Yeah, they don't care who the opposition is. They still play the same game.
Yeah, that's what made Ohio State number one. Remember, they weren't playing strong opposition, but they were so dominant. It's the same thing right now.
We can argue, we can sort of argue about positioning here, but the bottom line is we all agree that Oklahoma is the fourth seed, and that means Jalen Hurts is going to a fourth straight college football playoff.
That is amazing.
The guy who was benched at Bama, and guess who's going to watch him from the couch?
Yeah.
That feels like a topic for later in the program.
It may come up.
Maybe. Yeah.
Oof. On the way on SportsCenter AM, this is the Sunday brunch menu. Talking about the best vintage of the 2019 college football season. Is there such a thing as breakfast sangria? I don't know. Will it be an Ohio dynasty or a newcomer from the Southeast? Our sommelier for the top four is live. Plus, James Harden boiling over. Why the beard is getting all the talk on a night where it should be about Brody.
That's your favorite food.
There's no crying in your cheering O's necessary. Coach O getting jacked for our Sunday Funday, but his equipment manager, maybe a little bit more cardio. I'm not sure. We're going to tip your servers, clean our plates. How about an appetizer?
Yes, it's what to expect in Saturday's best. And look, agility is important. And against Hawaii, Boise State's John Hightower, can you please explain to me what this move is? I think it looks like a fuete. Just point the toe and we're sticking you in the nutcracker.
It's like a pot de beurre.
36-yard touchdown. Perhaps the best game of his season as well. 7 catches, 141 yards, couple of scores. Including that one right there. Boise State won the Mountain West. You win with more of Saturday's Best on a Sunday. Next.